Hey everyone, Jason here, digital marketing consultant, and in this Google Ads Fast Track Guide, you're going to learn how to set up your first PPC search campaign in under 15 minutes. Timestamp table of contents in the description, along with some other helpful videos if you want to take a deeper dive on setting up your campaigns. Now, there are only three things you'll need before we jump into my screen. You're going to need your keywords, you're going to need some ads, and of course, you're going to need a landing page. Now, first things first, keywords are how we tell Google when we want our ads to show up. Simply, keywords are representative of the people that we want our ad to go in front of. So when someone types something into Google and we think that search phrase represents someone who would be interested in buying our product or service, then we tell Google, hey, we want to show up there. Now, there are a lot of keyword research tools. You can spend hours doing keyword research, but let's get this campaign up and running fast. So I'm just going to give you some keyword formulas and then show you how you can use something called a search terms report to actually get better keywords as you start to optimize and scale. So here is a list of keywords that you can use right off the bat: location plus service, profession plus location, and best. And of course, you can pause the screen here and look at the different examples, but all you need is 5 to 7 keywords from two of these examples. That's all you need to create your first two ad groups. Now, what's something that's really cool is once you've chosen your 5 to 7, these are actually going to change into 21 to 14 keywords using something called match types, which you'll learn about when we jump into my screen. So you don't need to have a ton of keywords to get started. You really do want to be focused. And once you run traffic for a week or two, you'll be able to go to something called the search terms report. And this is where all of the search phrases you show up for will actually appear. So what's awesome is Google will actually tell you the exact phrases that are working and the exact phrases that aren't. So when we jump into my screen, I'll show you how to get to this place, and actually you'll be able to use this report to quickly figure out which keywords are going to be better versus spending hours on the front end just kind of guessing in the dark. Oh, I think this keyword is going to work, or oh, I think that keyword is going to work. You don't have to do that. Just use these templates and then move on to the next step, which is coming up with your ads. So when it comes to Google Ads, you have three headlines, then you have a description or URL path, and then you have your actual description. Now, you can do other things like site links, but we're not going to get into that when setting up your first campaign. So you have up to 30 characters for your three headlines, and your headlines should just be calling out specifically to who you want to be clicking the ad. Then in your URL paths, something that's really cool that you can do is you can use phrases like limited time, sale, or discount, or book now, even if it's not your exact URL. So it's a great way to use that limited ad real estate to really get people to click. And finally, you have 90 characters in your description, and this should just reinforce everything that you've done in the headline. Now, how the heck do you know what to write with your ads? Great question. The best place to go is to look at ads that are already running. And actually, if you're going to be doing search ads for any period of time, I'd highly recommend at least once or twice a week, go to Google and search in your search phrase and see what ads are still running. So if you do this for a week or two, you'll actually be able to see which ads are actually working and which ones aren't. And of course, there are fancy softwares that do this for you, but you can skip the $200 or $300 a month you pay for those and just do it manually over a week or two, and you'll see which ads are continuing to work. So what you want to look for in other people's ads is you want to look for promises, results, unique selling propositions. What are they offering to get people to click on the ad? How are they trying to differentiate themselves? And then, of course, what is a common string or thread that you see everyone talking about in their ad? Now, of course, if everyone's talking about it, it's an opportunity for two things. Number one, you should include that in your ad. Or number two, it's an opportunity for you to stand out and say, you know what, we actually don't do XYZ. And then if someone's reading all those ads, they'll see, oh, everyone's talking about this one thing, but this ad says they don't do it. So maybe they're different, or maybe I should click on them. And that's really all there is to it, to creating your ads. Something that's very important is you're always going to be testing your ads, so you don't need to stress over getting the perfect one. So just write 3 to 5 ads in the beginning, and you can use the same set of ads for each one of your two ad groups that you're starting with, and you'll be good to go. Now, the final element we have before we dive into my screen and build your campaign, of course, is your landing page. Now, this could be, of course, a video in and of itself, but all a landing page needs to do is to collect someone's contact information so you can follow up with them. Now, what's very important about a landing page versus other pages on your site is there are no external links. The only thing someone can do when they hit your landing page from your Google ad is enter their name and email or name and phone number, whatever information you're collecting. Of course, the more information you ask for, the lower your conversion rate. Link in the description to a video that walks you through how to optimize a landing page and put that together via whatever software you choose, or choose a software if you're not quite sure what the heck this whole landing page thing is. So long story short, all your landing page needs to do, have no links, specifically talk directly to your prospect and tell them how great their life is going to be as a result of opting in for whatever you're offering them. And so with these three elements locked in, you're ready to dive into the Google Ads interface and build your first campaign. We don't want to overcomplicate it, so let's just get started. Let's start spending at least $250 to $5 a day. And within a week or two, you'll have all the data you need to start making some real big changes and adjustments. So with that, let's go ahead and dive into my screen. Now, inside of our Google Ads account, we're going to click on campaigns so that we get this giant blue plus button in the top left-hand corner, and we're going to go ahead and click on new campaign. Now, if you are already very specific on what you want, we could go ahead and select one of these. I'm just gonna go ahead and click campaign without goal. I always like having more control, and I'm gonna click on search. So here's where you're going to decide whether you're doing search or you're doing display. What's very important is whichever one you choose, you only do that type of advertising inside of that campaign. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on search here, since display is gonna be a little easier. And we're just going to go ahead and click continue. Go ahead and give our campaign a name here, PPC management. And you see, this is where if you select search, it's going to give you the option to do display as well. We're not going to do that. We do not want display. So we're going to uncheck that, and we're going to go ahead and click show more settings. And this is where we're going to set our end date. So if we're going to be doing this for a week, I'd come in here, select the end date, and say, we're gonna do this, and it's gonna go to, maybe we'll do 2 weeks for this one. But this is a great way to make sure that our budget doesn't go over, because Google will just keep spending that money. And we'll go ahead and leave URL and dynamic ads alone for now. Locations. Now, if you're a local-based business, you're only doing business in your state, a specific, you know, neighborhood, city, or zip code, this is really where you want to zero in on the zip code, the neighborhoods, or the cities that you want to target. Now, typically what I like to do, because we manage a lot of different types of accounts, if whatever the largest geographical region you're focused on, enter that as your targeting, and then add all of the sub-targeting that can go inside of there. For example, if you're in the US, you can target a specific state, and then you target all the zip codes inside of that state, and then you'd also target the major cities or major neighborhoods. That way, you have a lot of overlapping targeting, and as time goes on, you're going to be able to figure out which cities, zip codes, and neighborhoods perform the best. Of course, if you're in a different country, you can still focus on different provinces or territories. You can apply the same type of target location targeting here. Languages, typically, I just leave it at the language of the country that the client is for. And next we have audiences. So audiences, this is where if you're doing display, right? So we're setting up a search campaign right now, but if you're doing display, you're going to want to click on audiences, and then you're going to click on this in market. So when we click on in market, you're going to see all of these different options. And there are a lot of drop-down menus here where you can really, really get customized here and see all of these different ones. I mean, this goes on forever, but hey, it's Google, they track everything, they look at everyone, so they know what's up, they know what's going on, and there are just so many different options here. Dating services, I didn't mean to click that. We're gonna X that out. So in this particular instance, since I'm doing PPC management, I would come in here to business services, click on advertising and marketing, and I would check this box, and I would check this box, and then I do some more research. I won't waste our time now to come up with a couple others. But this is what, those are the two that I would check in this particular instance if this was a display campaign. Of course, we're doing a search, but I'm just showing you what that would look like for a display. And leaving it at the default is fine. Used to be bid only. We don't really need to worry about that right now. Budget, this is the budget that we're going to set each day. Let's just say we're spending $10 a day. And delivery method, we'd leave it at standard. Accelerated just means they spend your money faster. It's not really going to help you collect better data. You want data that's going to show you over a period of time as opposed to what happened on Monday or Tuesday or whenever you start this campaign. And when it comes to how you bid, you actually want to bid cost per click. And the reason you want to bid clicks is because if you're doing this for the first time, you don't know what your conversion rate is. You don't know who's going to be converting. Once you have conversions, then it makes sense to optimize for conversions. We're just going to start at the standard $2 per click since we're doing search. And under show more options, you're going to have the ability to add an ad schedule, which I recommend even if you're doing it all hours of the day, and then an ad rotation. I typically just leave this alone for now. You can select rotate ads indefinitely, but please only do this if you actually plan on checking your account at least every other day. If you're busy with other things in your business, just leave it on optimize. It's not ideal. We personally always click do not optimize, but that's because we're in our accounts and our client accounts every single day of the week. If you're not going to be in here almost at least every other day, just leave it at optimize. Ad extensions, we're going to leave those alone because that's not necessary for our initial search. So as we click save and continue, we're finally going to be able to drop in our list of keywords. So I go ahead and paste them in here, and then I'd give the ad group a name. So I'm going to call this buy, and then the product, that would be the product name. And once we've pasted these in, what we can actually do is copy them again. We're going to click enter a couple times, and then you'll see down here there are different types of keywords. So we can actually have broad match, phrase match, and exact match. And really all this is telling Google how specific the search needs to be in order for your ad to show up. Broad means Google's going to match your keyword to a bunch of other keywords, and then phrase match, they're looking for just keywords that include the keywords, and then exact is the exact keyword search that you have here. So what you're going to want to do is come in here and put parentheses around all of your keywords. Now, obviously in your example, in when you're doing this, you're not going to have product in brackets because that's actually going to throw Google off quite a bit. And then we'd come down and one more time, control V again, and then we'd put the entire keyword phrase in brackets. Of course, product wouldn't be in brackets, right? And we do that for all of these. And then once we're done, we're gonna go ahead and click add a new ad group and paste in our next set of ads, or not ads, next set of keywords, and then do the exact same thing. So we do phrases here, phrase match there, and then we'd go ahead and, on the last two, that wasn't phrase match. There we go. Quotations, not parentheses, and then we'll do brackets for everything else, right? So we'd go ahead and do that at least three, if not four times, and then we can go ahead and click save and continue. And the final step of our process is actually creating our ads. So hopefully you already have some ad copy ideas based upon searching your search terms into Google. So we'd go ahead and first start by pasting the final URL. So this is the page that you actually want people to come to. We'll enter our headline 1 and 2, headline 3, and then you can go ahead and put your URL path. So what's really cool about these, again, let's say we do limited time offer, right? Something like that. You can see it comes up example.com limited time offer. So it's a great use of real estate, and you don't have to actually change the URL that you're using. This will just go on the back end of whatever your actual website is. We have our description lines here, 90 each, and then we go ahead and add our URL options if we're doing any custom tracking, which you're probably not. And once you've done this, you can click add new ad, and you'll do this for each one of your ad groups, right? So I did two ad groups here, so I would go ahead and do this twice, and then we'd go ahead and click save and continue, and we'd be ready to create our campaign. So I'm going to X out of this and go over to a campaign that I already put together. And inside of our campaign, you'll see the three ad groups that we created. You can set your default cost per click. I'm gonna go ahead and click into AdWords Management Services, and you see this ad group wound up just having two, and I typed exactly in what the services is. Again, I made this campaign in the exact same way we just went through. And with that, you are all set up and ready to go. Now, another quick bonus tip right here. I know this is a bit of a long tutorial. Let's go ahead and I mentioned earlier that you're actually gonna be able to use something called a search terms report when you've started to run some ads. So once your ads have run for a good week or so, you spend a couple hundred dollars, you can come in here and you can click on keywords, and then you can click on this thing up here called search terms, and this is gonna list all of the keywords that you've actually showed up for. And this is where you're going to get the best keyword ideas ever. So we've started with a small kind of templated set of keywords, and this report is going to populate and show you the keywords that you can add to future campaigns, future ad groups for optimization. And that's all there is to it, to setting up your Google PPC campaign. So go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe if you got some value out of this video. Comment below if you have any questions on putting together your Google Ads campaign. And as always, keep building the business you love.